Hello everyone, I am Tanvi Kaur and I welcome you to this series called RBI 247. In this very series, we pick up some important financial topics and we try to discuss them with the help of different questions. So for all those who are there for the very first time, you can subscribe to our channel and press this bell icon for all latest updates and notifications. You can also join our Telegram group. In this very group, we share some free quizzes as well as the updates for all our latest videos. Without wasting any time, let us move on to question number one, which says, funds parked by Indian individuals and firms in Swiss banks jumped to 2.55 billion Swiss francs, that is over 20,700 crores in 2020. UK topped the charts for foreign clients' money in Swiss banks and India was placed at 51st place. Which of the following correctly states the reasons for people preferring to invest in Swiss banks? So we have heard that a lot of people keep their money in Swiss banks. हम लोगों ने काफी सुना है कि Indian black money Swiss banks में पड़ा है, India का कितना पैसा Swiss banks में पड़ा है. So why are Swiss banks so popular? Why people prefer from all around the world to keep their money in banks in Switzerland? So let us have a look at this Swiss banking. Why is it so famous? And then we'll move on to how much Indian money is there in the Swiss banks. So if I talk about why Swiss banks are so famous, itna kyun mashhoor hai Swiss bank, itna log kyun prefer karte hai Swiss banks mein paisa rakhna. So there are three main reasons which support this. The first one is that the Switzerland economy is quite a stable economy and they have low levels of financial risks. तो अगर हम स्विट्जरलैंड की इकोनॉमी की बात करें तो कोई भी वॉर होती है तो वो उससे दूर रहते हैं. कोई भी टाइप का कॉन्फ्लिक्ट होता है कंट्रीज के बीच तो ये अपना एक न्यूट्रल पोजिशन मेंटेन करके रखते हैं. सो स्विस इकोनॉमी इज वन ऑफ द मोस्ट स्टेबल इकोनॉमीज ऑफ द वर्ल्ड. It has stayed away from any kind of war which might come up. Moreover, as far as the conflicts are concerned, it has always maintained a neutral stance. So it has not been involved in any of the conflicts in hundreds of years, and thus their economy is a stable and neutral economy. And when the economy is stable, there are low levels of financial risks associated. Agar aapki economy stable hai, aapka banking system usse itni easily affect nahi hota, itni easily volatility nahi aati, to aapka jo bhi paisa wahan pe hai wo safe rahega kyunki wo economy mein bahut ups and downs nahi aayenge. So your money is safe in a stable economy because it will not face the various ups and downs which other economy might face and thus can hamper the money you are keeping over there. So this is one of the major reasons why people have preferred over the years to keep their money in Swiss banks. The second and the most important reason why over the years people have kept their money in Swiss banks is the high levels of privacy. प्रिवेसी की टर्म्स में स्विस बैंक सबसे ऊपर रैंक करते हैं. स्विस बैंक्स में जो पैसा आपका पड़ा होगा वो बहुत सीक्रेटली मेंटेन रह सकता है. आपको किसी को बताने की ज़रूरत नहीं है कि कितना पैसा आपका उन अकाउंट्स में पड़ा है. इनफैक्ट दे हैड अ सिस्टम वेयर योर आइडेंटिटी वोंट बी डिस्क्लोज. ओके, वट एवर ट्रांजेक्शन्स आर हैपनिंग दे विल हैपन बेस्ड ऑन अ यूनिक नंबर कोड विच दे विल असाइन यू. So your identity will be based on that number, not what is your name, who are you. So these banks were not allowed to disclose their secret information about their clients, that who is the client, who is holding money over there, how much money they are holding. So it was a criminal act to disclose such information. In terms of privacy, Swiss bank law prevents the banks from disclosing any information regarding the account. Even किसी और को ये भी नहीं बताते थे कि ये account exists कर रहा है इस depositor के name में. But if we talk about the scenario now, the level of secrecy has reduced now. Okay, the days when Switzerland banks served for providing top secret accounts are gone. काफ़ी प्रॉब्लम्स आती थी कि जो पैसा वहाँ पे होता था लोग अपना ब्लैक मनी वहाँ डाल देते थे. ये एक टैक्स हेवन की तरह माना जाता था कि यहाँ पे लोग अपना पैसा रखते थे ताकि वो टैक्सेस अवेड कर सकें, जिसकी वजह से काफ़ी प्रॉब्लम्स आती थी. सो ये क्योंकि इन्फॉर्मेशन कोई डिस्क्लोज नहीं करते थे, लेकिन those days are gone now. Now it's not that they are not at all disclosing the information. there are situations when the some kind of a criminal record is there against the person. So in that case, the countries can seek information from Swiss banks related to those clients. In fact, Switzerland now has pacts with US, with India and different countries wherein it will share the information about the clients with the respective countries so that the people don't evade the taxes and the money which is kept over there is not black money. So we'll discuss in the upcoming slides really about this automatic exchange of information. So automatic exchange of information tax matters can now exchange information between Switzerland and India, and this has been in operation since 2018. Itna samajh lo abhi ke liye ki information jo hai clients ki wo exchange ho sakti hai India aur Switzerland ke beech. Ye 2018 mein decide se force mein hai. And moreover, Swiss banks are now more cautious with respect to opening of the client's account, with respect to keeping the money when it comes to non-Swiss residents who want to open Swiss bank accounts. Aise hi aapka account nahi khul jata, there is proper documentation before opening an account, and thus it maintains high level of cautiousness when it comes to opening the accounts of non-Swiss people. Alright. Then the third reason why people prefer keeping money in Swiss banks is strong banking system. They have a large amount of high capital requirements. Okay, and if the banks are maintaining enough capital, obviously, and if any situation which is not in favor of the economy also comes up, then they will have enough capital available to support them. And they will also be able to ensure strong depositor protection, which practically ensures that any deposits will be safe from any financial crisis or conflict which might come up. ऐसा नहीं है कि Swiss banks बहुत ज़्यादा interest rate offer कर रहे हैं जो आप लोग जाके वहाँ पे पैसा रख रहे हो. No, they are not known for high interest rates. Okay, it's not that they are offering a lot of interest rates that people are depositing money. No, the major reason why people deposit money over there was a stable economy system, high level of privacy, and strong banking system which they had. Alright, so let's move further now. Why I am discussing about Swiss banking? Because recently the data was released where we got to know how much of Indian funds are actually parked with Swiss banks. So like our RBI is our central bank which publishes the annual report. Similar way, the Swiss National Bank is the central bank for Switzerland which publishes its report called the annual banking statistics for 2020 this time. Okay, so every year an annual banking statistics report comes up which shows the financial statements of the banks in Switzerland. This very report also shows how much of the funds are parked by foreign individuals and enterprises in Swiss banks. So ek particular section hota hai jahan pe mentioned hota hai ki kitni total liabilities hai Swiss banks ki towards India, ki kitna paisa unko dena hai Indians ko wapas. So we have a particular section in this report relating to total liabilities which shows how much amount the Swiss bank need to repay India. So the funds parked by Indian individuals in Swiss banks jumped to 2.55 billion Swiss francs over 2700 crores 2020 mein. In 2020 jo ye amount Indians ka parked tha Swiss banks mein, ye 20700 crores se exceed kar gaya hai, and it's a really very high level. In fact, the highest level in past 13 years. This happened due to sharp surge in holdings via securities and similar instruments. So although our customer deposits in those banks fell, but the number of securities which we were holding, other instruments which we were holding, they have increased, because of which we have seen an increase in the funds with the Swiss banks. So if I move further and show you the data, this is the data for past 15 years. To around past 13 to 15 years, here you can see that the out of all this, the highest 13-year value, okay, from 2008 onwards, if you can see, the highest value is now in 2020. Se pehle la highest jo gaya tha wo 2006 mein gaya tha. Okay, and since then we have seen a fall only, with exception of few years. So in 2006 we had a record high value. After that, we have seen a downward trend. You can see with a slight rise in around 2011, then in around 2013, yahan pe thoda sa rise hua tha. Then we had a rise in 2017. Okay, but past 2 years, we have seen a downfall, and this year again, we have seen a rise, and it's a 13-year highest value which we are seeing now. Alright, so this is basically a picture which I have picked up from there, this very banking statistics statement only. So talking about the rise in the total liabilities of the Swiss banks, that is जो Swiss banks है उनको Indian clients को कितना पैसा वापस देना है, कितनी उनकी liabilities है जो उन्हें Indians को वापस करनी है. So what comprises of total liabilities of the Swiss bank? One is directly the amount of deposit with customers are making in the banks in Switzerland, around more than 4,000 crores. Then there are funds which are held via the other banks in Switzerland, so they amount to 3,100 crores. Then some amount is held over there through fiduciaries, through trust, which is around 16.5 crore. And the highest component of all of these is other amounts due to the customers. So there are some bonds which people are holding over there, some securities, some financial instruments. So they amount to nearly 13,500 crores. So ye 2,700 crores mein se jo 13,500 crore hai, this major amount is related to other amounts due to customers jo aapke bonds, securities ya baki financial instruments ke form mein Switzerland mein hai. Now these four components, all four components declined during 2019, but is saal humne yahan pe bahut major rise dekhi hai is very component mein. So what are the problems associated with this? They do not indicate the quantum of much debated alleged black money held by Indians in Switzerland. कहा जाता है कि लोग अपना black money वहाँ रख रहे हैं, तो इस data से हमें नहीं पता चलता कि कितना money white money है, कितना money black money है. Secondly, these figures do not include money that Indians or NRIs other might have in Swiss banks in name of third country entities. So हो सकता है A firm की या A person की कोई entity B country में हो. Suppose a person from say India has a unit in say Mauritius, okay. So a person Mauritius में अपनी कोई entity खोलता है. So from Mauritius he then makes a deposit in a bank in Switzerland. So वहाँ से उसका money Switzerland में deposit होता है. तो Swiss के accounts में show होगा कि Mauritius से पैसा आया है, ना कि India से. So these are third country entities. So these figures are not shown via this data which we are getting. So these things get ignored when we study this data. Now talking about a very important thing, is the money in Switzerland or in Swiss banks all black money? हम लोग जो कहते हैं कि इंडिया से जितना भी पैसा लोग जमा कर रहे हैं स्विस बैंक में सारा का सारा ब्लैक मनी है, तो क्या ये बात सच है? The answer to this question is no. Not all money in Swiss banks is black money. Swiss authorities have maintained that assets held by Indian residents cannot be considered as black money and actively support India in its fight against tax fraud and evasion. So, जो Swiss banks हैं, वो proper documentation के बाद ही accounts खोलते हैं. They do proper documentation to open the accounts and they also support India when it comes to people trying to keep money over there in order to evade taxes or to indulge in some tax fraud kind of things. So how they are supporting? Through an automatic exchange of information in tax matters, which is in force since 2018. So what happens under this automatic exchange framework? Under this, the detailed financial information on all residents of India having accounts with Swiss financial institutions since 2018 was provided for the first time to Indian tax authorities in 2019, and this is to be continued every year. So last 2018 mein jab ye hua tha implement, to tab Indian tax authorities ko sab Indian residents ki jinka paisa Swiss accounts mein hai unki information di gayi thi, taki Indian tax authorities unko tax kar sake aur tax log evade na kar paye. In addition to this, Switzerland has been actively sharing details about accounts of Indians suspected to have indulged in financial wrongdoings after submitting prima facie evidence, and such exchange of information has taken place in hundreds of cases so far. ऐसे कई cases होते हैं कि लोग अपना पैसा वहाँ रख देते हैं और वो money black money होने के chances होते हैं, या कोई गलत activity के through वो पैसा raise किया गया होता है. तो in that very cases, Switzerland ने हमें कई cases में सारे उन persons की information share की है इंडिया के साथ. सो ऐसा नहीं है कि ब्लैक मनी था वो हिडन रह गया, सारी इंफॉर्मेशन शेयर हुई है, टैक्स अथॉरिटीज ने अकॉर्डिंगली टैक्सेस भी लगाए हैं. सो वी कैनॉट से दैट ऑल द मनी इन स्विस बैंक्स इज ब्लैक मनी ओनली. although people used to do so by keep in order to enjoy the benefit of secrecy with respect to Swiss banks, but these kinds of pacts have reduced those secrecy levels and so the chances of evading the taxes. Moving ahead, what does our finance ministry say with respect to this rise which we have seen of more than 20,700 crores? So, हमारी फाइनेंस मिनिस्ट्री का ये कहना है कि क्योंकि टैक्स इवेजन को प्रिवेंट करने के लिए ऑलरेडी एक फ्रेमवर्क था पिक्चर में, तो अचानक से इतना इंक्रीज इन डिपॉजिट ब्लैक मनी के दौर पे तो नहीं हो सकता, या फिर अचानक इतना ज़्यादा डिपॉजिट तो होने का कोई रीज़न नहीं है, क्योंकि जब आपको सीक्रेसी का बेनिफिट अब नहीं मिल रहा, इन्फॉर्मेशन शेयर हो रही है, तो क्या रीज़न हो सकता है कि लोग अपना पैसा इतना स्विस बैंक्स में रखेंगे? In view of existing legal arrangement for exchange of information, there does not appear any significant possibility of increase in deposits. So, finance ministry ka manna hai ki kyunki ab taxes to evade kiye nahi ja sakte, to aisa koi major reason nahi hai ki aapki itni zyada deposits badh gayi hai Swiss banks mein. So, finance ministry has also requested Swiss bank to share the data, relevant facts and figures that why we have seen this rise in deposit numbers. Other than that, the ministry also believes that these are few reasons why we have seen a rise. Kuch 5 reasons diye hain jinki wajah se hamari deposit badi ho sakti hai. One of them is that there has been an increase in number of business transactions which are happening owing to business of Swiss bank branches in India. Or another factor could be increase in deposits owing to business of Swiss bank branches located in India. Other reasons can be that there has been an increase in the interbank transactions which are happening between two countries, or it might happen that some Swiss company is having a subsidiary in India and it has raised some capital from India, so a capital increase for subsidiary of Swiss company could be other reason. And lastly, one more reason which they have cited is increase in liabilities connected with derivative financial instruments. So proper data finance ministry ne request kiya hai Swiss bank se ki share karo ki aap ye changes जो इतना मेजर हुए हैं ये किस रीजन की वजह से हुए हैं. ऑलराइट, दिस इज व्हाट आवर फाइनेंस मिनिस्ट्री हैज टू से. नाउ मूविंग बैक टू आवर क्वेश्चन, वी हैड टू आइडेंटिफाई द रीजन व्हाई पीपल प्रेफर इन्वेस्टिंग इन स्विस बैंक ओवर द इयर्स. फर्स्ट एंड सेकंड आर द रीजन, कोई इंटरेस्ट रेट ये बहुत ज्यादा नहीं देते हैं. ओके, सो दैट्स नॉट अ रीजन. आंसर इज ऑप्शन बी. नाउ मूविंग ऑन टू क्वेश्चन नंबर 2, व्हिच सेज RBI has decided to grant in principle in response to expression of interest notification dated 3rd November 2020 published by the PMC Bank. According to this expression of interest issued by the bank, investors looking to acquire were invited to ideally bring in the capital for enabling and achieving a minimum CRAR of 9%. Which of the following financial services group has been given this in principle approval? So here it is, granted in principle approval. Okay, this word is missing over here. So they have granted, RBI has decided to grant a in principle what? In principle approval. Who, along with a fintech startup Bharat Pay, will proceed to take over PMC? PMC की क्राइसिस हुई थी जिस वजह से लोगों के डिपॉजिट्स वहाँ फंस के रह गई, तो उन्होंने एक एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ इंटरेस्ट निकाला था कि जो भी इंटरेस्टेड है हमें टेक ओवर करने में, दे कैन टेक ओवर आर बैंक. सो दे आर आस्किंग दैट विच फाइनेंशियल ग्रुप अलॉन्ग विद भारत पे गेव द प्रपोजल टू टेक ओवर PMC. द आंसर टू दिस क्वेश्चन इज ऑप्शन ई, सेंट्रम फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज लिमिटेड. सो लेट अस हैव अ लुक एट दिस PMC केस. PMC stands for the Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank. As the name suggests, it's a cooperative bank, a multi-state cooperative bank which is functioning in Maharashtra majorly and also in Delhi, Karnataka, Goa, Gujarat, Andhra Pradesh and Madhya Pradesh. It has been given the scheduled status by Reserve Bank as well. So we had seen a fraud case coming up with respect to PMC. So telling in a very brief manner about the PMC case, क्या हुआ था इस केस में, इन्होंने एक ही एंटिटी या एक ही कंपनी की अलग अलग एंटिटीज को बहुत ज़्यादा अमाउंट का लोन दे दिया था वो लोन एनपीए हो गया था बट उसको डिस्क्लोज नहीं किया गया था, उन्हें स्टैंडर्ड असेट दिखाया गया था, डमी अकाउंट्स बनाए गए थे, सारी इंफॉर्मेशन को छुपा के रखा गया था आरबीआई से. सो द बैंक वायलेटेड आरबीआई नॉर्म्स ऑफ एक्सपोजर. 6500 करोड़ ऑफ वर्थ ऑफ लोन वर गिवन टू 44 एंटिटीज ऑफ एचडीआईएल. सो 73% ऑफ द बैंक्स असेट्स वर यूज्ड टू गिव लोन्स टू एचडीआईएल एंड आरबीआई नॉर्म्स सेज दैट यू कांट गिव मोर देन 25% एंड फॉर इंडिविजुअल कंपनी. This is for the connected company group and this is for individual company group, the limit specified. But what this bank did, PMC granted 73% exposure to HDIL only. And then HDIL started defaulting on its loan, but PMC didn't classify it as an NPA. They concealed the information from RBI. In fact, they created thousands of dummy accounts. Alag-alag namo ke dummy account bana diye gaye aur unke through HDIL ग्रुप को लोन दिया गया. दे डिड नॉट डिस्क्लोज HDIL अकाउंट्स टू RBI एंड दीज अकाउंट्स इवन इफ रिपोर्टेड वर रिपोर्टेड एज स्टैंडर्ड असेट्स व्हेन एक्चुअली दे वर डिफॉल्टिंग अकाउंट्स एंड दस इररेगुलरिटीज वर नॉट ब्रॉट टू RBI's नोटिस. सो व्हाट वाज द फेलियर ऑन पार्ट ऑफ द बैंक? इट डिडंट वर्क वेल एज फार एज द फाइनेंशियल रेगुलरिटीज आर कंसर्न्ड. So there were major irregularities with respect to finances in this bank. They failed to maintain the internal control systems of the bank and there was wrong or under reporting of the exposures as well. So when these things were brought into notice, RBI ceased its operations and the people were not able to withdraw more than 1000 and but later on this was increased that they can withdraw 10,000, then 50 and then 1 lakh, but still a lot of depositors are there whose money is still stuck up. वो अभी तक अपना पैसा PMC बैंक से नहीं निकलवा पाए हैं. Now talking about the way forward, now what RBI is doing. So I have already told you that in principle, expression of interest was basically offered by the Punjab and Maharashtra Cooperative Bank where it invited applicants for taking it over. So RBI has decided to grant an in-principle approval to Centrum Financial Services Limited to set up the small finance bank. And the RBI would consider granting a license for commencement of banking business on being satisfied that they have complied with all the conditions. This is related to the EOI which was issued. So ye kya keh rahe hain? Ye keh rahe hain ki पंजाब पीएमसी बैंक ने एक एक्सप्रेशन ऑफ इंटरेस्ट निकाला था जहां उन्होंने टेक ओवर्स के लिए इन्विटेशन इनवाइट की थी कि आप हमें आके टेक ओवर कर सकते हो. तो उसको टेक ओवर करने के लिए सेंट्रम फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज और भारत पे ने मिलकर अपना रिक्वेस्ट डाली थी दैट वी वांट टू टेक ओवर दिस बैंक. सो आरबीआई ने उसको अप्रूव करते हुए इन प्रिंसिपल अप्रूवल दे दिया है कि सेंट्रल फाइनेंशियल सर्विसेज जो है वो एक स्मॉल फाइनेंस बैंक बना सकती है और लेटर ऑन हम इसको प्रॉपर लाइसेंस दे देंगे अगर ये सारे conditions fulfill karte hain initial approval ke dauran. So if I talk about this EOI, it said that the investors who are looking forward to take over PMC need to bring in some capital so that the bank can achieve a minimum CRAR of 9% and the investors can explore the option of restructuring deposit liabilities into capital instruments. So jo bhi aapka bank take over karenge wo logo ki deposit chahe to aise hi return kar sakte hain, chahe unhe equity mein ya capital mein convert kar sakte hain. And the bank may also approach DICGC. We all know that it approves, it provides some amount of insurance for the depositors worth 5 lakh. So this decision of RBI has ended nearly 2 anxious years for depositors. Okay, so now the PMC will be taken over by a consortium of non-bank lenders, Centrum Financial Services and a fintech startup, BharatPay. So Centrum, as I have already told you, is a financial services group. So you can see over here, they provide various services like investment banking, MSME, microfinance loans and other services. Okay, and BharatPay, we all know that they have a QR code with using which they accept the payments for any other app. So hame Google Pay ke through, Phone Pay ke through, Amazon Pay ke through, whatever through whatever thing we want to make a payment, we can use the BharatPay QR codes. Okay, so these two firms want to take over the bank and they have given a proposal to bring in 900 crore in the first year and then they will bring additional amount later on. So RBI will be in principle approval de diya hai, initial approval de diya hai and subject to conditions they will be given the license of a small finance bank. Now the question arises, why is there a need to give the status of a small finance bank? In a bank kyun banaya ja raha hai? The reason is that there is a rule that you can amalgamate two banks. So this new entity will be operational in 120 days. And then as per Banking Regulation Act, two banks can be merged together. So then they will merge the small finance bank with the PMC bank. So PMC bank or ye small finance bank will merge ho jayega aur iske jitne bhi deposits hain, liabilities, assets hain, wo sab aapka Centrum Finance ka jo bhi small finance bank banega wo take over kar lega. Now the question arises, will the PMC depositors get their money back? Kya unko apna paisa wapas mil jayega? So the answer to this question is still not very clear. RBI has although paved the way for joint venture of Centrum and BharatPay, but it has not yet decided about the details of the acquisition of PMC Bank. Kya kya cheeze acquire hongi, kaise hongi? If we talk about the past cases of bank mergers, we have seen that the money has been returned to the depositors in the form of fixed deposits. Fixed deposits ke roop mein logo paisa wapas mila hai. However, the banking experts say that while RBI has a history of full securing depositors, in such cases, the repayment will depend upon whatever scheme is agreed between RBI and the Centrum and BharatPay. Depositors kyun worried hai? Depositors are worried because if they are the very bank agrees that it will secure just 5 lakh amount, okay, then the depositors will be losers because some depositors ka 5 lakh se zyada amount ho sakta hai. And if their deposits are converted to equity, then there is a risk because the new finance small finance bank might register on exchange in a couple of years, not now. So again, the depositors will suffer. So while the core of its acquisition is to safeguard depositors' interest, the depositors could be expected to make some sacrifices, and this is because NBFC acquiring a bank is a rare case, and this is the only way forward or only solution available as of now. Now moving on to last question, which says RBI has come up with some regulations for payment and system operators relating to investments from FATF non-compliant jurisdictions. As per this, the new investors from these jurisdictions shall not be allowed to directly or indirectly acquire significant influence in PSO, which correctly states the significant influence requirement. So FATF stands for Financial Action Task Force. Ye ek global money laundering or terrorist financing ka watchdog hai. It's an intergovernment body which sees that the country should not be involved in money laundering, in terrorist financing. So this body sets up the international standards which aim at preventing any illegal activity or those activities which can harm the society. So this very FATF periodically identifies those jurisdictions, those countries which are weak and which don't take proper measures to deal with money laundering or terrorist financing. So ye do publication nikalte hain. One, they list the countries which are high risk jurisdictions, kafi risky hai, and they are not properly adhering to the necessary standards. Second are jurisdictions which are under increased monitoring. Unki thodi zyada monitoring ki zarurat hai. The ones which are not part of both of these are the jurisdictions which are FATF compliant jurisdictions, jo sare standards jo hain unko meet kar rahe hain. So what Reserve Bank decided in February, if you remember, they came up with a notification where some guidelines were prescribed for NBFCs. So investments which are coming from FATF non-compliant jurisdictions to these NBFCs. So what were those regulations? Jo bhi NBFCs mein investment honge, un FATF non-compliant jurisdictions se, wo agar koi naya investor kar raha hai, to he shall not be allowed to acquire significant influence. Wo bahut zyada voting power ya major influence us company pe nahi rakh sakta. So new investors from these non-compliant FATF jurisdictions, whether they are investing in some existing NBFC or in company which is going to be incorporated, which is going to get registration certificate. So those investors can't invest significant influence in those NBFCs. So significant influence ka yahan kya matlab hai? Ki 20% se zyada voting power wo us NBFC mein nahi rakh sakte. And so fresh investors from those non-compliant jurisdictions should in fact hold less than 20%, not more than that, voting power in NBFC. And if we talk about existing investors, they were allowed to hold their investments prior to classification of the source as FATF non-compliant. So they can continue with their investments or they can bring in additional investments also. But new investors ke liye requirements specify kar di gayi thi. This was for NBFC. Ab isko PSOs yani ki payment system operators ke liye bhi apply kar diya gaya hai. So new investors from such jurisdictions, if they want to make investment in the payment system operators, they can't have the significant influence, which is again 20% of voting power in PSOs. Existing investors can continue. So if we talk about payment system operators, payment system ek system hai jo aapko clearing, settlement of payments allow karta hai. That enables payment to be effected between payer and beneficiary. So it includes your electronic payment system, your debit card, credit card, online payment gateway, money transfers or prepaid payment instruments. So if we talk about some examples of this payment system operators, it includes NPCI. NPCI offers you the IMPS, UPI, NACH, AEPS, SBI aapko ATM network offer karta hai. Amazon Pay is there, Delhi Metro is there, Phone Pay is there, they are all offering the prepaid payment instruments. So, these are some examples of your payment system operators. Ke. So, if I move back to the question, the answer to this question is option B, that 20% se zyada threshold nahi hona chahiye. Alright. So this was all for today's session. So why they have said that the investment should not exceed this 20% threshold, because investments which are coming from those jurisdictions which are actually complying with necessary standards, they should not be treated as par with those who are not complying. Jo wahan se investments aa rahi hain jo comply nahi kar rahi un regulations ke saath, un standards ke saath, that means that they are risking our financial system as well. Such non-compliant jurisdictions signal increased risks which can affect our financial and banking system. So this limit to make sure that firms from such nation don't acquire substantial interest in our country's NBFCs or your PSOs. So this was all for today's session. I hope this session was interesting and useful for you all. With this, I would like to end up this session. Thank you so much.